Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Wang. Here's the question. We want to simplify this expression. Looks special. We have some absolute value sign outside, and we also have inside part. We also have an absolute value sign. This kind of problem is not difficult. It's easy to make mistake. Especially you have negative here, how to get rid of the absolute value sign. You have to follow the rule. So when we drop the sign, that means the inside part must be positive. How do you know inside part is positive? If it is negative, we have to put a negative sign in front. So simplify. So here, look at here, the first one. Okay. Inside part of the absolute value sign, how to drop inside part? So check it, inside part, square root of 2 minus square root of 3, this number is bigger than this number. We look at the inside part first. We know square root of 3 is bigger than square root of 2. So inside part, that's negative. If we want to drop the absolute value sign, we should put the front, a negative sign. So negative square root of 2 is here. And negative square root of 3 should be positive square root of 3. Right? This is the first part here. And also look at it here. Now, the whole thing, that's positive. So now the question is, this is positive, we can always drop this sign, right? Drop this sign. And here, look at this number and this number, which one is bigger? Square root of 2 plus square root of 3 is bigger than this number. So we can put this in front to make inside part positive. Otherwise, this is negative, right? Negative, you have to put the negative sign in front to drop the absolute value sign. So here, we just put the big number in first, then minus this. It is equivalent to say that inside part time negative 1. This part becomes positive. This number is always positive. So we don't need the absolute value sign here. And the square root of 5, put the negative sign, that's minus square root of 5. So now continue to simplify. Look at here. This is negative. We can put the negative together, group it. The two items, put them together. And here, because that's inside part, that's positive. This part is bigger than this. We can easily drop this absolute value sign. So look at here. Inside part is positive negative. Definitely negative. This part is bigger than this. So here it's negative. If we want to drop this absolute value sign, we should put the negative sign in front. Or just swap the order. Negative become positive, positive become negative. Right? So here, change the order here. And this is the first part, this bigger than this one. So here, that's minus square root of 3 here. And distribute this one to here, negative. Distribute to here, that's negative. Distribute to the last one, should be positive. So here, let me mark it. So here, we have negative square root of 2 here. We have negative here, right? And here is 1 square root of 5. Here's another 1 square root of 5. We can put them together as 2, right? So here, negative square root of 3, negative square root of 3. We can put them together. Then get the answer. You have 2 square root of 5 minus 2 square root of 3. We can factor 2 out. That's 2 times square root of 5 minus square root of 3. That's all. Thanks for watching. See you next time.